Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled Gated SR Latch Examples. For us to do an example of this, you should probably understand how a gated SR latch works in the first place. What I'm going to use is kind of this quasi-truth table, where rather than an output, what I've got is this description of a mode. In this particular example, what I'm looking at in this description of this SR latch, S stands for set. There's no bar above it. So that means when I have a 1, I set it. Enable. There is no modifier to that enable input. So when it's high, it's enabled. When R gets a 1, I am resetting it. What is set and reset? Well, a set condition is when Q has a 1 on it. A reset is when Q has a 0 on it. I'm going to describe these modes as set and reset. What are the other modes? Well, memory. Memory means it's going to stay the same and keep the value that was previously on it. Fill out the truth table just on the mode. Okay, think about this here. If it's active high enabled and I'm not sending a high, what's that mean? It means it's disabled. Okay, I'm not accepting inputs from the SNR, regardless of what SNR are saying. It's not enabled. So what mode am I in? I'm in memory or disabled. Okay, now I enable it. But I'm not setting it or resetting it. Well, what am I in? I'm in the exact same condition, except I'm paying attention to the inputs. I'm paying attention to SNR. However, I'm not receiving a set or reset command. So I'm in memory. Okay, next one. I'm enabled. I am not setting it, but I am resetting it. What mode am I in? Probably reset. Okay. Now, what I want to do is move on to a condition where I am enabled, I am setting it, but I am not resetting it. What am I doing? I'm in the set mode. And finally, I'm in a condition where I am enabled, and I am simultaneously setting and resetting that. What mode am I in? Well, that's probably not a good idea. That's invalid. So what we're going to do is just do a timing analysis of this on a timing diagram. I've got S inputs, I've got R inputs, I've got an enable input, and I've got a Q output. So what I'll do is I'll just put data on S and R, enable and Q, and take it from there. Okay, so there's the inputs for S, there's the inputs for R, and there's the inputs for enable. And now what I'm going to tell you is what is the initial condition, Q? Let's say Q starts at logical 0. And the way I like to do these timing diagrams, and this is, again, this is a quiz question, an exam question. Do you know how a gated SR latch works? I'm going to give you a timing diagram. If you can do this, I have absolute confidence that you know how this thing works. And here's how I do it. Enable. Look at the enable. That's the most important thing there. Draw brackets around the enable. This is the only time it's listening, is when there's a 1. This is the only time when it's listening to those SR inputs. Anything outside those brackets is going to be ignored, because why? You're in that state. It's disabled. It's not accepting SNR inputs. So regardless of what SNR are doing, ignore them. And Q was a 0. I gave that to you. And it's going to stay a 0 until it gets into that bracket. Now let's start looking at our timing analysis. The device is enabled, and it's looking for high inputs on SNR. And as we progress from left to right across here, it's receiving no inputs on SNR until this moment right there. What does it receive? It receives an active high S. What does that do? It sets it. It's still enabled, and it stays a 1 for that whole time, but it's still looking for inputs on SNR. Does it receive any within that bracket? The answer is no. And it becomes disabled, i.e. enable goes to 0. Ignore everything between those brackets because it's not enabled. Even though you're getting this set it. You didn't hear me set it. You didn't hear me set it and simultaneously reset it. It doesn't care because it's not enabled. And it just continues on its merry way as a 1, ignoring all that noise. However, this bracket comes along here where it is enabled. And it continues on its merry way of being a 1 until it gets this active high reset command, at which point it resets and continues on its merry way of 0 until it gets an active high set command at this point right there. and it sets. And what does it do? It continually looks in that period where it's enabled. It continually looks for inputs. However, it receives no other inputs beyond this final S, and it stays 1, at which point it is disabled, i.e. it does not accept S or R inputs, and it continues to be a 1. This output queue is how I can tell you understand or you do not understand how a gated SR latch works. Now, that example was done with a queue as a 0 input. Queue as our 0 initial condition. What if queue, exact same inputs on S and R and enable, if Q was a 1? Okay, your timing diagram output should look different. Same S and R inputs, same enable input. Q happens to be initial conditions 1. What do I do? Exact same way I did it previously. Look at the enable. Draw brackets. Okay, from here to here, it's looking at the S and R inputs. From here to here, it's looking at the SR inputs. It's ignoring everything previous to that. If it was initial conditions 1, it's going to stay 1 until it gets into that bracket, at which point it starts looking at the S and R inputs. It receives no inputs in that period until right there. It's a set command. It's already set. What does it do? It stays set and continues that way until the device is disabled. It receives a command to set, set again, simultaneously set and reset. It's ignoring it because it's disabled. Finally, there's another period where the device is enabled. What does it do? It continues on its merry way until it finally gets a reset command right there. It goes down to a reset condition, i.e. a 0, and stays a 0 until it receives a set command. During that time it is enabled, it goes up to 1 and stays a 1 until the device is enabled and enters that memory or disabled state again. Same exact S, R, and enable input, different initial conditions, different output waveform. Let's do another example of this. Okay, so here's another timing diagram example of a gated SR latch. Got our inputs S, got our inputs R, got our inputs enable. And now here's something super tricky. Q is unknown. Okay, I don't know what Q is. Q could be a 0. Q could be a 1. What it is, it really is an unknown condition. Okay, so what I can do is kind of do that cross hatches on the timing diagram because it's unknown up until the point I get a valid input to it. And that would look something like this. And you should be asking yourself, why did he stop right there? And the reason why I stopped right there is because at that point, it enters a known condition. Why? Because look at the enable. First thing, bracket out the enable. When does it start looking at inputs? Between here and here, and between here and here. All other input combinations are ignored. So what happens at that point, and that point exactly, is we get our first valid set command in a region where it's enabled. What does that unknown go to? Well, it goes to a known 1 condition because we receive that set command. So if it was a 0, it goes to a 1. If it was a 1, it stays a 1. The point is that's the first time we get a known value. And we walk right along. We receive a reset command. What's it do? It resets within that particular enabled region. Now, something tricky happens. Going along, we're enabled, no other inputs. Uh-oh, we just drove our car off the cliff. So let's pretend they're simultaneous. We are simultaneously setting and resetting. This is an invalid region. I know I said it's invalid. However, what really happens, both Q and not Q become a 1, which is still invalid because you can't have the complement of something being equal to that something because that doesn't make sense, okay? So Q does go to 1. It's still invalid, and we stay in this invalid region until both of them are removed. In a perfect world, those edge transitions occur simultaneously. In reality, they don't happen that way. They could have the S transition as 0 first, and then the R. Or the R first, then the S. Point of the matter is you don't know. And it might be different on Tuesday than it did on Wednesday. There's an invalid region. We have entered which state is Q in. We don't know. When do we know? The next time we get a valid input. during that enabled window. It's right when we get that next set command right there. At that point, it leaves that unknown zone, goes to a valid set condition. So this is an interesting timing diagram here. We started with an unknown. We were in the unknown region until we got a valid S command. Now we were in an enabled region. We got a simultaneously set and reset value. What happened? Well, we don't know after that. There was a brief period. We could have stored a 1. We could have stored a 0. However, we were enabled and we gave a valid set command, so we recovered from that invalid region. The point of the matter is don't drive your car off the cliff. That's what the purpose of the enable command is don't simultaneously set and reset when it's enabled. Yes, you can have S and R both being a 1 during a period of not enabled, when it's disabled. Yeah, do that as all you want to, but you don't do it when you've got an enabled, because you'll have this potentially wrong data in there. Let's continue. We're now in the disabled zone. What's going on? Well, nothing. We get a reset command. What happens? Nothing. We're disabled. We stay a 1 until we become enabled. We'll check it out. Right at that moment we become enabled, we are getting that R command. What happens? Cleared out, we're reset, and we're enabled. And at that point right there, we get a valid set command, and our output goes high. Okay, so our timing diagram should look something like that. Let's try another example of this. Okay, so let's try this example here. Got our S input, our R input, our enable input, and our Q. And let's say Q's initial condition is a 0. And now, before you begin this, I have hidden a landmine within here. Okay, there's something extremely tricky about this, and has nothing to do with the timing diagram. Has everything to do with that. Go ahead and try this if you feel ready to do this. Here is how I'm going to do it. What does that bubble mean on enable? Okay, the previous examples have been active high enable. This is an active low enable device. How am I going to do this? I'm going to do this exact same way I did the last time. When's it listening? Okay, when's it listening is when enable is low in this particular case. It's listening from here to here. And that's the only time it accepts S and R inputs. So we were at 0 and Q is going to stay 0 until it gets this first set input. And what is it going to do? It's going to set, it goes to 1, and then it's going to get another set input. What happens when you lock a locked door? It stays locked. It's going to stay 1. Finally, receive a reset command. It goes down, resets, it goes to 0. We are still within that active low region going along, and we receive a set command. What's it do? It sets. And it's still saying, hey, set it, set it, set it, set it. But now it's going to stay set, at which point the device becomes disabled and it ignores any further input, including this final set command, because it's outside of the enabled region, i.e. active low enabled region. These are great tools for you to try out, these timing diagram analyses of SR latch examples. You should be pretty well acquainted with the gated SR latch by now. Let's step it up a notch and talk about the D latch, was a little bit further functionality of our sequential devices.